Hello everyone. Thanks you to be here today for my session. So I will speak of Grafana and how to use it with a Salesforce API to in a Salesforce environment. So first thing first, my name is Jérémy Vial. I'm developer at TechSay since 6 years. I work on multiple projects like Covea, G2R, and now Meilleurs Agents. And I'm also a mentor on the Open Classroom course of Salesforce developer. So what is the context? 1 year ago, when I go to Meilleurs Agents, I see a big screen at the wall. And as I'm curious and I like numbers, I was interested in it. And I asked the team, what is it? And this is a reporting of a lot of constants of the Salesforce org. And as I think this is a very interesting to do that, this is not something we see everywhere, to make a generical project and present it to for everyone can use it. So why is the point to outsourcing your monitoring? The first thing is that it's not always easy to monitor in Salesforce everything. There is many menus, different pages that is not very accessible sometimes, and also it takes time to check every day. This is also difficult to set up a time tracking because you can see the constants, but you can store it in the org, or you need to implement a layer of logic like a trigger or a flow. It's also costly and take energy if you want to aggregate data from other systems than Salesforce. And the first, last thing is if someone need only to check metrics, you will need to get a license that takes yet a cost, and sometimes you can't pay your license just to see the metrics. So I choose three tools for free that you can use to set up this Grafana project. The first one is Grafana. This is a free software that you can use to enable data visualization. There is a free version on cloud, but you can install it on-premise if you want to. I use two GitHub actions. Normally you use it for CI/CD on your GitHub project, but you can also use it as a cron. So I create a Python script to run at regular interval and use it to insert the data that you checked in a database. You have a free version too, that is enough to do what we want. And you can use also other tools like Rundect, Promise, like on AWS if you want. And the last one, this is InfluxDB. This is a time series database, so exactly what we want to do, to track in the time different constants. And there is also an open source version on cloud, but you can get it on-premise too. If we get an overview of all these tools, so we have the GitHub action that will run every 20 minutes, for example. It will check every constant that you want to store via API from Salesforce, but also API status Salesforce if you want to check if your pod is alive or not. And every API that you want to insert in your Grafana and track in the time. The GitHub action inserts to in InfluxDB the data that you want to store. And Grafana will plug with the connector in InfluxDB, and you can get in shape data and create graphic and so on. So let's see a bit of the setup. So from Salesforce, you don't need so much things, just a connected app and a technical user to connect to the API, and a specific profile and permission set to get only the right that you want for this user. This is just check the API and get SOQL via API. Tac. The GitHub setup. So you will set up a GitHub action script. In my example, this is Python, but you can use other languages. I made two scripts different. One will run every 20 minutes, the other one every hour, because you don't want the same frequency for every constant. And the script will insert in the database. So if I go in the different tools, so in the GitHub action, here is my project. I made a README to install it easily, so I will give the link at the end of the session. So the script is in form, the cron is in form of YAML, for example here. So you have the cron that is scheduled here. It run on the main branch. It uses Linux to run. This is the setup, and you install some packages of Python, and you load every credential that you need, and then run the script. One thing I like with GitHub Action, this is the way it stores your credential. You just have to go to Settings, Secret, and Action. And here you have all your credentials that we want to store secretly, and it feels enough secure, I think, to do this and not to put in the package directly. You have also the script. This is on the script folder. I will go rapidly on this. So you import different packages that you need. Mainly simple Salesforce to create your API call, and in FluxDB. So you load again your credential, you init the connection to Salesforce, and you have all your stuff to store. I don't go in detail. And at the end, you insert in FluxDB the record that you created. So this is the part of GitHub setup. For the InfluxDB, in the cloud version, you can see this is the overview. And it works with buckets. Typically, mine is a triple F here. And you can check your data directly via the interface. For example, if I want to check the API limits, I go limits, done. Daily API requests, submit, and I saw all API calls that I did in the 24 hours ago. I can also change the time, and if I go in script editor, I directly see the request. If I don't, I am not able to create mine, I just can take this, copy-paste in Grafana, and it will work. So this is the part of InfluxDB. And the last one, Grafana, the main one. Tac. So Grafana, this is again the cloud version that is free for three users. So you can use it easily. If I go to the dashboard that I created, this is easy to access. And here you can see every constant that I want to check in the time. So if I go in more detail, I have the last update here. So the script run at 10 p.m. 22. I can see the current pod of my org, the health security score. That means this is a score that Salesforce gives for your org to see if secure or not. So I can see this is not totally secure, and I create a little array in the background to see what I need to do to improve my security org. So I can see that the certificate is not big enough. I have one certificate that is expired, and so on. So I can see directly what I have to do to secure my org. Also, once again, you have the daily API limits that you can see here, and all the limits that are given by the API limits of Salesforce. You have two ways to see it. You can choose personally what you want. I have also recall storage tracking here. So I can see that all my account is created in the org. I cannot create anymore. I have 13 megabytes created. And that represents 14.5% of the data storage in my org. So if I can see that it go to 100%, take action to reduce it or do something. I have also the incident pod tracking, so I can see that my pod is okay since 5 p.m. So it's a good thing to know. If you got a disruption, you can see directly that you got it. You have the metadata limits too. You can create as metadata as you want in your org, for example, for permission set. Here you can see that there is a limit, and you can track it too. And the last one, this is the login localization that I like, because I can see where people is connecting to my org. And maybe if I see someone connecting from India or China, there is a security problem, and take action of it. All the US connection is from Grafana, so it's okay for this side. And I also can track the total license of the org. So here I can see that I have no license remaining. So I can take action, contact Salesforce to get more licenses if I see this is the case. I have a small thing to do. So I created the diapo with all that I say here that you can download after the presentation. You have also the KPIs that you can create via SOQL. So you can display again convert rate tools for lead, number of calls that your team did in the day, tracking sales revenue, and what you want to track directly on the screen that you want to display in your. And you have also a Slack integration that you can put. So if there is alert that you can set up in Grafana, you can directly see it in Slack and get alert with what you want. In the end, there is some limitation of this little project, the limitation of free tools. For example, for the database, you can only see 3 months of data, but if you pay, you can get more. The GitHub Action is not 100% readable, because sometimes there is a high load of the GitHub server, so the trigger will be decalé in the time. So if you want to get something very reliable, maybe you can go in the other another tool, like I said earlier. If I go in the diapo, like Rundeck, for example, that is more reliable. And the last one is the limit of API available for tracking, because if you have an API that not available for tracking something, you can take can track it and get it in Grafana. Finally, I put the code publicly in my my GitHub account. So if you want to test it, you can download it if you want. It's totally okay, and that's all for this session. If you have some question. Yes, you can get a notification email. I don't so present it, but you can go here in alert. If I remember. Yes. Yes. You can set alert for everything that you are tracking with Grafana. Don't remember.
This alert will be sent if the UI is not displayed.
Yes. I don't remember where it is. Maybe here. Yes, create a new report, and you can schedule the report. But you have also alert. This is the report. You can schedule it when you want. Select the name of recipient, and so on. You can test the email and check the report. For example, I didn't select the dashboard, but tech. If I want a sixth tracking, tech. I can preview what we will send, and if it works. So it generates the preview of the PDF that you will receive. Yes?
I have two questions. Can you please show me what all you are monitoring? Like, where did you define, okay, I want to monitor this?
Yes.
So you're pretty much monitoring a lot of things, you know? So where did you define that? Can you show me?
Where you define what you want to track?
And how do you track? So Grafana cannot just accept any kind of data. Somewhere you do the transformation, right? Like,
yes.
You take the data from Salesforce and you put it into Grafana.
Yes.
Can you also show me where this data?
Yes, everything is in the script that I will share with in my repo.
Yeah.
So if I go there again, so I have different parts. The first part, I will connect to Salesforce with simple Salesforce.
Yeah. It's easier to read here because there's a lot of light.
Okay. then I put all parameters to store, to logging.
Yeah.
And then this is a small script, like for example for limits.
Yeah.
So I call my limit API.
Yeah.
And I store in this way everything from the response from the API.
Okay. But, and here you have all the things listed what you want to query. So you're querying APIs, permissions.
Yes.
Okay. Did you also try to save database transaction time? So let's say I insert a new account. How long does it take to insert an account, or how long does it take to insert the contact? Did you try to do that?
Yeah. No, I didn't try. I didn't get the ID, but it's a good ID to did.
And this data where you save in the database, it's the schema is like the schema of Grafana, so you don't have to like do some magic on the way. Where do you feed the data to Grafana?
This is here.
Here it's in the database, right?
Yeah, it inserts this kind of record in the database.
InfluxDB, and then GraphNum picks it up from InfluxDB itself.
That's it.
Okay. Why do you need GitHub Actions and not like a Lambda function or something, which is like a serverless function which can just keep running it?
I didn't try it, but I think this is possible.
Or do you use Salesforce functions, but you have to buy them?
Maybe, but it's costly, so so all projects cannot use it.
Okay, but Lambda will also work, right?
Yes, you can use Lambda, but I didn't use it since now. I don't know if you have to pay to use it.
On no? Firebase.
Okay. Yeah. So you can use it. Yes?
Is it mandatory to use InfluxDB?
No, I think you can choose the database that you want. This is more easy to use it because this is a time database, so it's easier to follow constants during the time. But you can take what database that you want to track. There is a connector for every database, I think, in Grafana. Yes?
Just a small one. Maybe it's not kind of a question, but maybe a suggestion, because I can see that you're using username password flow to authenticate. So are you planning to add something, I don't know, GWT flow, or use something in Salesforce authentication URL, which you can generate from SFDX? So maybe just to simplify, you know, the authorization flow without the need to store username credentials inside of GitHub.
You can do it. But I didn't think to do it for now, but it's totally okay to do it.
Yeah.
You can see the documentation of Salesforce.
Yeah, but it's just maybe a suggestion, you know, just provide different flows, so just bigger flexibility. Just one more thing.
Yes?
You also mentioned that you were showing converted rates of leads, so here you're also retrieving records, right?
Yes, you can retrieve record via SOQL. You can use a simple Salesforce to query directly the API, or you can use the API directly from the native Python calling function.
So mainly the brain of, let's say, this application is here in Python stream, because it decides what to retrieve, how to transform, and how to send to database.
Yes.
And all the rest is just infrastructure and visualization of data, right?
That's it.
Okay, yeah, cool. Thanks.
Yes?
Would it be possible to integrate the Grafana website, I would say, in directly in Salesforce, in a dashboard?
Maybe, I think in iframe, I think it should be possible.
But then you don't need graph now, like you can just query data from your org, put it in an LWC, put on a graph. Yeah. Okay.
Yes?
Sorry. You mentioned API API scanning. Can we show the difference between REST and bulk API calls?
I don't understand the question. Can you reframe?
In the graph,
yes?
You show us API calls monitoring? API calls monitoring?
Yes.
Yes. Can we see the difference between the different types of API calls?
Ah, I don't think so,
okay.
Because this is the return of the limit API, and by it you can't see who is calling the API. So this is a limit, I think, of the system. This is over, so thank you, and if you want, if you have questions, you can ask.